Hello friends, in this video I will be discussing with you regarding myopia, astigmatism, hypermetropia, aphakia, presbyopia, accommodation of the eye, contact lenses and radial keratotomy, and at last we will be discussing regarding the LASIK surgery. Okay, so what is myopia? So myopia refers to nearsightedness. The person is able to see the nearby object very much clearly rather than the farby object. So why it is happening exactly? The myopia happens because of the change in the curvature of the cornea. So if you don't know cornea, go for the first year syllabus eye anatomy, so you can understand what is the cornea. So if you don't know really what is cornea, what is lens, please quit this video right now and please go for the another channel. So right, we discuss again further more about the myopia. Now myopia refers to nearsightedness. The person is able to see nearby object very clearly, and he cannot see the farby object. So what kind of lens we can use? We can use a kind of concave lens, which is a plus diopter lens, to treat this myopia. Myopia again, it is a refractive error. It is also called a nearsightedness. You have to remember this always. It is a 10th standard syllabus. Okay, there is nothing much more rocket science in this. So myopia can also be corrected by using contact lenses, either LASIK surgery. LASIK surgery we will be discussing in the later time of this video, and we can use spectacle. We already told a positive diopter power lens we can use to treat this. Myopia, it is usually occurs in both adult age as well as in the younger age, juvenile age. Okay, the people are able to see the nearby object very much clearly, and they cannot focus over the farby object. Like they cannot see the traffic in the on the road. They cannot see the vehicle, small vehicle. They are coming near to them. They cannot see. Okay, this was a road accident because the far sightedness is not there. The far sight is not there. So because of that, they possess major problem of road accidents. Next comes is the astigmatism. So what is an astigmatism? Astigmatism, it is also a kind of refractive error where the person is unable, he cannot see the nearby object as well as the farby object. The nearby object he cannot see, the farby object also he cannot see. Why it is so? Because the eye, the accommodation of the eye, we'll be discussing that thing also right now. Accommodation means the power of the ability of the eye to change its focus. Means if an object, for example, this stethoscope is there. If I move the stethoscope from this distance to this distance, I can see this stethoscope very much clearly. Why? Because my power of the eye has the power to change its focus. Here it changes its focus, it is near, and here it is changing its focus, it is far. So it can change its focus on its own, and then that is called as accommodation. So when the power of the eye, the ability of the eye to change the focus is lost, or the curvature is congenitally lost, or it changes because of any disease like ulceration is there, trachoma is there, any kind of, because of the infection, the curvature of the eyeball, even in the glaucoma, the curvature of the cornea or the lens, entire eyeball shape or size changes, and the ability to focus on the object changes, whether it is nearby or it is farby, and that time it is called as an astigmatism. Okay, so what is an astigmatism? Astigmatism refers to incapability or inability of the eye to focus both the nearby object as well as the farby object is called as astigmatism. So how will you correct when the nearby object is unable to see and the person is unable to see the farby object? We use for bifocals. The nearby we go for concave lens. For farby we go for the convex lens. So when he cannot see both nearby and farby, what we'll do? We do bifocal, means it is a mixture of both concave and convex. The above will be the convex, the below lens will be a concave to see the nearby object. Nearby object is always seen by while reading your books. When we are unable to see, it is called as myopia. Okay, to correct that thing, we use concave lens. Okay, so that's why we use a concave below. In the spectacles, you see a different kind of lens. If you have elder people in your home, you could see the presbyopic or glasses spectacles. When in which the below lens will be a concave and the above lens will be a convex. So this is about the astigmatism. So next comes is the hypermetropia. What is hypermetropia? The vice versa of myopia will be the hypermetropia. hypermetropia. What it will be the hypermetropia? Hypermetropia refers to far-sightedness. The person is able to see the far-by object very clearly and he cannot see the nearby object clearly. He cannot see, he cannot focus the nearby object. The ability of the eye is lost to see when the object is very near. This is called as hypermetropia. Okay, so mainly the school children, when the far away the board is, the teacher will be writing on the board, the child is unable to see the far away object alphabets or the words over the board, and because of his academic performance goes down and the teacher beats him a lot. Okay, telling him he is not concentrating over the studies, though it is not that case. So hypermetropia refers to a kind of refractive error where in which the person is unable to see, the child is unable to see the faraway object, the teacher writing on the board, he cannot see what has been teaching on the board. So this is the main problem within the children. So how can you correct this thing? By using spectacles again, by using contact lenses. Contact lenses are usually very sensitive, so they cannot be handled, they have to be cleaned all the day, and it is very sensitive to the eyes because the infection because of the contact lenses is very often. So using of the contact lenses by the children is not recommended usually, and even LASIK surgery is not recommended, and usually the children are treated using the spectacles only. What kind of spectacles we use? We use a minus diopter, which you call lenses are used, like convex lens or kind of thick convex lens is used to correct this hypermetropia. So hypermetropia, again it is caused because of the flattening of the cornea. Why it is caused? Because of the flattening of the cornea. Cornea is curved like this. Okay, in the first year anatomy of your eyeball, you could understand what is the shape of the cornea. So whenever the cornea, instead of the convex shape, it changes to some, its curvature is changed, its wavelength is increased. Okay, now it is less curved, it is length has been increased, okay, not wavelength, the length of the cornea, if it is increased, then the cornea is unable to focus the light properly, okay, to pursue the light properly, the vision light cannot pursue properly, and because of that, the child, especially an example, he cannot see the faraway object. So this will be a hypermetropia. Now what comes the aphakia? What is aphakia? Aphakia refers to complete absence of the lens. Within your eyeball, you have something called as a lens. First comes the iris. First comes the cornea. Behind the cornea, there will be an iris. Iris, the black color part of your eye. Behind the iris, there will be the lens, which has been within the place. The eye, the lens will be like this. Okay, this shape, and it can contract, it can relax, contract and relax. And this causes the accommodation, that is focusing power of the eye. So whenever the lens is completely absent, either because of the cataract surgery, after removing the lens during the cataract surgery or for the cataract surgery, the condition, it is called as aphakia, or it may be congenital as well. The congenitally, like some people, they do not have one limb, limbs like upper limb, lower limb, the absence of the limb or spondylitis, the congenital symptoms will be there, some congenital conditions will be there. At that kind of condition, when the eye ball doesn't contain the lens itself, then that condition is called as congenital aphakia. Okay, even a trauma causes trauma, ulceration, okay, surgical removal of the eye lens, that is extraocular extraction of the cataract, which is called as, okay, during all this condition, the eyeball is called as aphakic. So we use aphakic lenses, that are thick convex lenses, to treat the refractive error, which is caused because of loss of the lens of the eye. Okay, this conclude with the aphakia. What is presbyopia? Now we will discussing about the presbyopia. Presbyopia refers to, again, same as that of the astigmatism, but the presbyopia occurs in the old age. And the person is 40 plus age, at that time the presbyopia occurs. Now what is presbyopia? Again, the nearsightedness and farsightedness is totally absent. He cannot see neither nearby object, neither he cannot see the faraway object. So the presbyopia refers to absence of, total absence or nearsightedness and farsightedness, totally absent. So again, how we will treat? We will treat by using bifocal lenses, that is combination of convex and concave lenses. Okay, so why it is happening? Now why presbyopia is happening? So astigmatism is happening because of change in the curvature of the eyeball. Curvature, the size, the shape of the eyeball has been changed because of any kind of infection or glaucoma is there. So underlying condition causes the astigmatism. So why presbyopia is there? It is because of the aging. Because of the aging, the radial muscles which helps in contraction and relaxation. Okay, this is the, if it is a lens, okay, if it is a lens, the contraction and relaxation of the lens, if it is lost, okay, at that time the focusing power of the eye, that is to focus over the nearby object, to focus over the far by object, okay, this ability is lost. Whenever it is lost, it, that condition, it is called as presbyopia, and it is occurs in the old age, that is 40 plus age, and it is due to loss of the functioning of the ciliary muscles or the ciliary muscles, the ciliary body. What is ciliary body? What is the uveal tract? We have to know in the anatomy book and read the anatomy part of the uveal tract. Okay, then comes with the contact lenses. Now let us discuss with the contact lens. So what is a contact lens? Contact lenses are either made up of the flexible plastics. They are flexible plastic kind of material that fixes over the cornea. They are usually used to correct the refractive errors. Some models or in the filmography, okay, or whatever you call it, in the cosmetic use, to treat the eye color, to change the eye color to iris color, they use the contact lenses. Their cosmetic use as well as for the refractive error as well, they are boldly used. The contact lenses are very common nowadays in the fashion industry. So contact lenses are again the flexible plastic material made up of the plastic, usually plastic. They are very sensitive to use because they are very prone to infection. Okay, the main indication, again, the myopia, presbyopia, hypermetropia, astigmatism. So this will be the condition where in which we use the contact lenses, but children are not recommended to use the contact lenses, okay, because the infection, chance of the infection is very high with the contact lenses, and it may even cause the ulceration within the eye, because any damage to the cornea can lead to ulceration or infection. Again, the subsequent sequence of the infection can go on. So we don't recommend the lens, contact lenses, to each and every individual who cannot maintain the, you know, this one, what we call the sterilization part, required for the maintenance of the contact lenses. So next comes is the radial keratotomy. What is radial keratotomy then? The radial keratotomy refers to a surgery, a manual kind of surgery which uses the blade. Any surgery, manual surgery, we use blade, scalpel, blade is will be there. Okay, the same thing for the in the ophthalmology to treat the myopia, especially it was developed by a Russian ophthalmologist to treat the myopia, the nearsightedness, to treat the nearsightedness, to treat by recurvaturing the cornea, the recurvaturing of the cornea by using blade and the scalpel, and that is called a radial keratotomy. This here incision is made to correct the curvature of the cornea to treat the myopia. Okay, it was radial keratotomy. It was called as radial keratotomy. Now it is outdated because nowadays the LASIK surgery, that the last part what we are going to discuss, the LASIK. What is LASIK? LASIK, LASIK. LASIK refers to laser assisted in situ keratomeliosis. Laser assisted in situ keratomeliosis. Here we use powerful beam of light to correct the curvature, of the cornea to treat myopia, presbyopia, astigmatism or hypermetropia. Okay, we treat all of these things by using the laser. Laser is very sophisticated, sterilized part, and less of disadvantages or contraindication are very less during the LASIK surgeries. Okay, because of this, now the trending part of today correction of the refractive errors is the LASIK surgery. LASIK surgery is commonly practiced, but still it has a disadvantages. That is, the main disadvantages is the refractive error. Whenever you grow, okay, as the person grows older and older, the refractive error comes back even after the LASIK surgery. So the LASIK surgery may have to be re-established to correct the refractive error. So this was all about the refractive errors and the accommodation part of the ophthalmology. So thank you for watching my video.